system, you can see the information. Okay. So what are the information? Okay, let's talk about the infotainment system first. So it is 10.1 centimeter, right? 10.1 inch, sorry. And it has weather, AC, all the information basically you can see, and you can see the 360 monitoring system for the vehicle. You can watch around all the places, 2D and 3D you can check.
Energy regeneration kinetic system, okay. And just beside that you can see it is in normal as of now, mm-hmm. So you can change it to sports, normal, or eco.
Right,
and apart from that you can, this is the TPMS,
yeah.
And this is like you can set the brightness level and all these things. So there are three screens basically. One is about motor dynamics, second is about TPMS, third is about the brightness
level.
You are seeing that it's in KERS 3. So in KERS 3 what happens is it's like a single pedal drive. You just, okay, you can leave the system and it, you can see that it is going in negative, right? Mm-hmm. The motor speed, mm-hmm, is going in negative over, mm-hmm, there. So what this means is your motor acts like a dynamo,
mm-hmm,
and the power is regenerated and is stored back in the battery. So this is very convenient for city drive,
mm-hmm,
though this particular vehicle doesn't have a single drive feature as such,
mm-hmm,
but using KERS 3, mm-hmm, it works like a single pedal drive.
Okay.
You just leave the acceleration pedal, the vehicle will decelerate itself.
Okay. And this is the button from where we can engage it, right?
Yes.
We can change the KERS.
So some of the other Indian vehicles which are EVs don't have a setting for KERS,
mm,
right?
Okay.
And I'm not sure about Hyundai makes, but yeah, MG's, even the previous variants of this version had the three levels of KERS.
Okay. And this is how it is displaying about your flow of the air, AC flow. Now let's see how quickly it goes to the top speed. We'll check. It's pretty quick, definitely. Okay. It's quick.
And this was in eco mode.
This is in eco mode. Yeah, right. So not even in the sports or hyper mode. So.
And you can see the KERS 3 file. I just left the pedal and vehicle stop.
Okay.
And you can see the power coming to negative over here.
Okay, okay, good. I think acceleration is very nice actually. It's kicked very quickly. Now I will show you interesting feature regarding your blind spot, how it blinks. Indicating you that some vehicle is coming from back, and that's the good feature about car. You get the turn, I think it will start displaying your area to the right or left wherever you're moving, so that is automatic kick in.
Sports mode makes it.
Yeah, let's go to the sports mode. Careful, cops ahead. Oh, it's already 83. Okay, this is cool. Power is really good.
So this is Sports Plus KERS 3, and I did not even press the brake.
Okay.
It decelerated completely.
It decelerated automatically, right?
Yeah.
Okay. It's a nice feature. Saving the kinetic energy, right, to the battery. It's
yes, and the current goes in negative whenever KERS is
negative, right?
Whenever KERS is activated, you can see now it's going to minus 28
minus
ampere.
20, yeah. This is how they manage the power.
So in general, this is called as regenerative braking.
Regenerative, yeah.
And this term was famously made popular by Teslas.
Teslas, okay.
Yeah. But MG calls it KERS.
Okay. Alright, this is the charging station, and my brother, he will explain about this.
Yeah, right. So this charging is powered by a company called Fortum, which has Charge and Drive. So this is a 50 kilowatt DC charger. It comes with two connectors. So this is called CCS2.
Okay.
So you can see this is a type 2 socket which we have at home chargers, which is AC type, and this is the DC type.
Okay.
So in this one, it will charge both parallelly, and this is a 50 kilowatt charger. So technically, with a 50 kilowatt charger, you should be able to go from 0 to 100% in this vehicle in flat 1 hour.
Okay.
And this is the other type of connector. It is called CHAdeMO.
What is that?
It is called CHAdeMO.
CHAdeMO.
So this charger is not used in India. Okay. This was put up thinking that Nissan will come up with some of its vehicle
EV,
like
Leaf
or something like that. Basically, this connector is used mostly by the Japanese vehicles.
Okay.
And the CCS2 has become a de facto Indian standard now.
Okay.
So CCS and CCS2 both are compliant with each other.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, a CCS charger can also go into CCS2 slot.
Okay.
So on highways we will find this.
Okay.
And the best part about this is if there are two CCS2 guns in such a system, right?
Mm.
Both will load balance each other.
Okay.
So that no one has to wait for
okay.
their turn. They can charge in
they can charge parallel.
Charge
okay.
And
this
is all
pay and path. Pay
yeah,
and charge.
So they have, I think, 17.5 rupees per kilowatt. Either you can start it via the RFID or you can download the app and
you can charge it.
Start it from there.
Alright.
So there are multiple companies in this space now.
Hmm.
One is Fortum, one is Relux. The most popular ones are Xeon and Tata Power.
Yeah.
Xeon ones are much reliable.
Yeah.
And and best part is Fortum Charge and Drive across India is free for all the MG users till June 30th.
Alright. This is another one. This looks good in white as well.
Yeah. get confused about which color you have to take it. This is the white, and we have red, which is already parked there. So they are putting the number plate.